adopted from some traditions. In tonight's Teditorial, Teddy Locsin Jr. shares how the Pope's actions can change the Church.
The new Pope's acts may astound, delight, yet also raise skeptical eyebrows for the seeming attempt to pander to the fashionable minority that likes to criticize the Church for living like it does, privileged, complaining, and well. The vast majority of the faithful are poor and still pray fervently in church and shuffle up the aisle to the altar on their knees, in sincere expression of the fundamental Christian teaching that God is not deaf. He will not second guess what is good for you, and He will answer prayers, not in the better way He chooses, nor to make you shed tears, as Teresa de Avila patronizingly said. He will give exactly what you pray for, provided you really are in need. He will console you if you are really grief-stricken. The vast majority of Catholics do not mind the rich panoply of church ritual and dress, because you go to a king for help and protection, and not to the weak and poor who cannot provide them. All Catholics are monarchists. They serve one king, Christ, on earth as in heaven, and again on earth when he returns to a remade world. Still, some of his acts give one pause. Instead of taking the papal limousine after his election, he joined the other cardinals in the shuttle bus they had taken to the conclave where he was elected. He returned to the hotel to gather his things and paid the bill himself, rather than walk out with the assumption of a Filipino politician that the Chinese businessman at his heels has already taken care of everything. He did thank the cardinals for their prayers, though he hoped God would forgive them for inflicting the papacy on him. However, he added that he hoped the cardinals would not return to Rome for the inauguration of his pontificate, but by staying in their diocese to help the poor. And he conspicuously failed to automatically reconfirm all the cardinals and Vatican officials in their offices, making it clear that they would thenceforth serve at the pleasure of a stark pontiff who lived in a small apartment instead of a palace, cooked his own meals, tended to a sick old priest, and took the bus to do his pastoral work with the poor. None of this is new. It is, in fact, the oldest thing about the Church. Jesus said that those who live well shall not do so except in hell.